Hi everyone, I'm Göknur. Today we are going to present our deep learning model and we talk about our data set. First of all, the goal of the project detecting license plates at school entrances using deep learning models and comparing the detected license plates with the database by character separation and performing the removal or non-removal of barriers. And if you talk about our initial data set, first data set contains 433 image, 180 of them in dataset are repetitive and useless photos. As you can see in picture, cars 0 and cars 147 and others image, as you can see. And since only 253 image remained and this number was insufficient, we choose another dataset. This is Bayesian silica. You can see the link. And we add 457 images were added from this dataset. In this dataset, we did labeling because the vehicles in the image were not labeled. That is, they didn't have XML files that indicate the coordinates of the plate. And with labeling, our dataset reached 710. While labeling, we left a few images from the first dataset and compared the values in the resulting XML file with the existing XML file in order to check that process was progressing correctly. And this is first dataset and right one, we labeled them and there is no actual difference so much. And Elif Burcu will continue.
Hi everyone, I'm
Göknur. Can I ask a question, Göknur?
Of course, of course.
So, as far as I understand in the previous slide, you just combined two separate data sets, right?
Can you repeat again?
As far as I understood that, you just combined two data sets.
Yes.
Separate data sets. Yes. And now they have one single metadata, right?
Yes.
I think it will be good if you share this data set with me so that I can share these two data sets as a single one with the CSV file so that in the future other researchers can download and use this data set. Am I right?
Okay, of course.
It will be very good.
Okay, I will send you. Thank you.
Let's continue.
Hello everyone, I'm Burcu. I will continue. Firstly, I mentioned that transfer learning. Transfer learning is a method for feature representation from a pre-trained model calculating, as that we don't need to train a new model from scratch. A pre-trained model is usually trained on a huge data set, such as ImageNet. In deep learning model, Inception ResNet Y2 is a convolutional neural network that is trained on more than a million images from the ImageNet database. In our project, we used a most powerful model, Inception ResNet V2, while detecting the license plate detection. Here, we built the neural networks in COSE. Our output should be 4 because we have 4 plate coordinates. In compiled model, we need to define what is the learning rate and what kind of optimizer we want to use, and also what is loss function. Also, we use ADEM optimizer, which is neural networks. We look the model summary at the end. Sorry, teacher. We look the model summary. At the end, we add two dense layers, which is 50, 500 and 250. Also, we can see that our output is 4. Model training. In this step, we put the model on the train. If I need to mention our batch size and epoch number, our epoch number is 100 because as the number of epoch increase, the performance will increase. Also, we want to prevent memorizing by giving our batch size is 10. Here, We mentioned that model accuracy. We plotted the success rate of the model. It is seen that the accuracy rate increased as the number of epochs increases, but after a while it stays fixed. Here too, the model loss rate and the number of epochs are shown. As our epoch number increases, the model loss rate decreases and continues steadily. After tomorrow, we continue.
Burcu, may I ask a question?
Yes.
Could you please go the first slide of your presentation, your part?
Yes.
Okay. So you mentioned that you are using transfer learning for what?
For
reading the plates?
Yes, reading the
are
plates.
Are you sure? Are you sure? Please carefully listen to me. My question is that, are you using transfer learning for reading the plates?
No, sorry, teacher. Object detection.
Please. Okay, then move to next slide.
Yes.
The other slide. So explain us, what is the output of that model?
What is the output of that model in here? Coordinated.
Can you show us? Yes. On
yes,
the model. Explain us, because not everybody is familiar with that kind of model. So please explain us the last layer, why you set up these numbers, dance 500, dance 250, and dance 4. Why?
Dance 4, firstly, because we have four coordinates called x min, x max, y min, and y max in our data set. We take the dance 500 because also when we research the dance numbers, many people take the sum numbers and try. We are not sure about if can be 500, but also only we try because depends on project.
Okay, I see. So for the 500, 215 kinds of numbers, as a custom, we mostly use the sum numbers which is power to the 2. For example, let's say instead of 250, we use 256. Instead of using 500, we mostly use 512. Do you understand me?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, most of the time it is custom in deep learning using most of the time using some power of 2. Okay. And the last thing about your presentation, you begin with the model, but we didn't see any pre-processing. So we cannot understand how you input these images to the data, to the model. So just, I think the order of the presentation is not suitable for us, right? Because we have the data set, you pre-process the data set somehow, and then you have some initial model and the result. But now you are presenting the results before the pre-processing.
Yes, you are right, teacher.
Okay. So are you going to present the pre-processing, Pınar?
Teacher, I will present, actually I will create the pipeline and I use the pre-processing parts in pipeline, but I'm not sure.
Okay, let's continue with your part, Pınar. Let's continue.
In here, actually, we load the model as an object detection.h5, and I create the pipeline. Actually, I'm not sure about it is necessary in this presentation, but I did it, and I wanted to character reading with the result from our model. That's why we checked our visual by creating a pipeline. Here, first we have the image read. Then we apply the pre-processing part, which is dividing by the 255 and the reshaping our images to 224. Then we create a function that will print the coordinate information by framing the plate location in the car image. And then I made a prediction. In this image, the plate finds its location correctly. In this slide, in the text to the text in the conversation part, it covers the plate to the text correctly. But in the plate image, the last four digits is D943. If it is like that, it is true, but it is 0943. It is false. And in the other prediction, the plate does not find its place correctly and does not translate the text correctly, as you can see in the other slides. And I did the other image. The plate finds its location correctly, but when the converting the text, no output. Actually, there is no output. In here, we use the Tesseract library, but it is not helpful, actually. That's my opinion.
Pınar, yes, there is some confusion in your presentation. You are talking us first to transfer learning, right? Mm-hmm. And at the beginning of your part, you begin with the pipeline, but you didn't define the pipeline. What is the input? What is the output? What are the processes in that pipeline? You didn't mention. At the last slide, you mentioned Tesseract, and nobody knows what is Tesseract is. Only you know. Am I right?
Yes, you're right.
So actually, your presentation is very confusing for someone who is listening to you. So yes, it is very right. Confusing. It's not well prepared. It's not organized. So it is just some slides, but we cannot follow you. So what is the pipeline for you? What does it mean? What are the components of that pipeline? What is the input? What is the output? What are the parts of that pipeline? You are just showing us the code, but you didn't mention anything about, for example, there is a model.predict. What is that model.predict? There is other thing which is missing here. Where is the converting the text to or image to text? There is nothing on that part. So what I am suggesting that you prepare this presentation without coordination in the topic. So it's not easy for us to follow you. We just easily get lost. We cannot follow you.
Mm-hmm. Our input is pictures image from the model. Our input is it. And also model.predict.
But could you please draw a diagram for explaining this, not by the code, in a PowerPoint? Yes. You can draw some diagrams, input, output diagrams. You know this case, you know the case, right? You can use UML diagrams, but yes, you didn't explain us, so it's not easy for anybody. So if you report like this, your report will be very, very unsuitable for the reasons. Because you have taken the software engineering development, now it's just like looks like some shot screens. screenshot. So I don't expect such low quality presentation.
Teacher, yes, you are right. I accept that we didn't very good presentation.
Plus, where is the data pre-processing? Data pre-processing.
I did the data pre-processing part in pipeline, like reshaped our image.
It is just normalizing. It's not pre-processing. Did you rotate it? Did you slide it? There are hundreds of things that you can do with the images. Did you apply these techniques? Use the data augmentation techniques for images?
Not yet, teacher.
So again, I would like to emphasize that this is not a pre-processing presentation. You focus on only solution, and we don't need solution at that stage. It is 3 weeks later. At this stage, you need to ensure that after concluding the EDA, exploratory data analysis, then you apply some data augmentation techniques, and then you just employ these data set into some initial model, but it's our not concern. Our concern is how you apply the data pre-processing techniques on your data set. And there is not any clue on that presentation. Göknur, Elif, Pınar, do you understand me?
Yes, yes.
So please improve your presentation. I think we need to meet again, because that's not the presentation that I expect from you. You can do better.
Okay.
Do you have other things to explain, or did you finish?
Actually, I mentioned the R results.
Yes.
As a result of the models and methods we apply, we got a lot of errors in reading characters with Tesseract. We will try another deep learning method to perform character reading, or we will focus more on our pre-processing stage.
Okay, but Pınar, if you want to mention about your initial findings, you need to mention first how to split the data set, what's the ratio of data set that's split, then what are the accuracies, what are your metrics?
Okay.
You didn't mention this, so we don't know Tesseract is failing or not, because you didn't provide us any metrics, any accuracy metrics. You just show us one picture successful, the other one is not. So it is not an engineering approach like that. You need to tell us that, for example, we separate the data set such that 100 images in the test data set, and 80% of the time Tesseract wouldn't recognize the, I don't know, the plate, or 54% of the time we couldn't get the coordinates correct. I don't know such numbers, because you are engineers, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, you are right.
Anything else to report?
Actually, no.
Okay. So I want you clearly improve this presentation in two ways. One way is the organization, the order of the material. The second way, the content itself. Okay, please, please improve this, and let's meet again. All right?
Okay, teacher. Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.